along in chapter 2, starting on page 22, it starts talking about the role of the brain in learning and development, and we all know that the brain is a key component of our success. And one key player in the children's development is, of course, the brain, and there's four key points about the brain and its role in cognitive development. And we'll start with the first one. It says different parts of the brain have different specialties, but they all work closely with one another. There is no such thing as a left brain or right brain thinking, as we've been told before, even though there are some testing out there where they'll test your right and left brain. In this particular book, they don't think that that's really scientifically proven. So you'll have to do some digging on the right and left brain and see what you think. I do see some of the characteristics that I've read about right and left brain. I do see some of those characters when I'm thinking about myself, but maybe that's just happens to be a fluke. The second one says most learning probably involves changes in neurons and synapses. And if you look on page 24, learning involves strengthening, it says. And plus forming new ones. Effective learning requires not only that people think and do certain things, but also that they not think and do other things. In other words, that they inhibit tendencies to think or behave in particular ways. So changes in the neurons that is causing us to learn or not learn. And we're going to talk about more about that when we get on the memory and how those neurons come out and how to attach memories to it. Number three, developmental changes in the brain enable increasingly complex and efficient thought. As children encounter different stimuli and experiences in their daily lives, some synapses come in quite handy and are used repeatedly. Others are largely useless, and these gradually fade through a process of synaptic pruning. And so once again, we go back to what we just spoke about. Children having experiences. We learn from those experiences. Sometimes we learn what to do, and then sometimes what not to do. So I bet you could think of a time in your life that both of those have happened. You've experienced something. You either learn not to do it anymore, or you've learned that was a better way than what you had thought before. Lastly, the brain remains adaptable throughout life. The brain's ability to recognize itself in order to adapt to changing circumstances persists throughout the lifespan. There isn't a single best or only time to learn. The human brain never goes into lockdown mode. So any time you can get students to be motivated to learn, it's going to happen. And you think about think about kindergartners and maybe even back when you were in kindergarten, there's such a love for learning. The majority of the time students want to be there. They're so excited. They are a sponge just waiting to absorb. Wonder what happens. I don't think the brain goes in lockdown by no means, but it seems like as we get older, we lose that motivation, that thrill of learning, and then in turn, our development slows down. So if we can keep that motivation going, not only in kindergarten, but all the way up, I think we'd see significant growth in our students. I want you to watch this video, and then after watching the video, it's kind of like a test. I want you to text me what your answer was. And then we'll talk about that in class. Make sure you remind me because I want to tell you what my answer was. Have fun on that and enjoy.